In the past month, we have been forced into a completely new business environment, and no one really knows what the long-term impacts on society will be. But we know one thing, and that is that it's utterly important that we keep on doing business. Today, we will talk about how data can help you find new target groups and new customers. Welcome to Biznode Studio with me, Anna Olin Kadal. Yes, marketing is difficult, even more so now with budgets being cut and a totally different environment to communicate in. But it can be done and it should be done. Here to talk more about this is Biznode CMO Anna Albinsson. A warm welcome.
Thank you.
So from a communication perspective, what has changed pre-corona?
Well, I think that a lot of marketing managers have some kind of dual mission right now. You need to run business as usual and support your company with sales-driven marketing as you've always done. But you also have one mission to adjust your marketing activities to the times we are in right now, to do extra or marketing activities that are more into where our society are today when it comes to values and prioritization. And I think that a lot of marketing managers are trying to do a more purpose-driven job right now and try to explain why their business is important and what role they play in society. But it is a big challenge for marketing managers today to keep both business as usual and the new times running at the same time.
And probably with less budgets.
And probably with less budgets as well. So two missions with budget cuts. It's not an easy task.
Definitely not. So we were already advertising tied before Corona. Would you say it's even more so now?
Yeah, one way you could see it like that. During normal circumstances, we can see that about 80% of us are really sick and tired of misdirected communications. On the other hand, we are really open for ads that are relevant for us with relevant content and that is really into what I'm thinking about right now. Then we have a really high acceptance for ads. But nowadays, I think it's even more important to stay relevant. There are higher risks if you do not identify your target groups in the right way, and if you do not talk to them in a way that is brings value to them. So I think we really need to find our new target groups. You know, someone that wanted to buy a car 3 months ago might just have lost his job and that is not relevant at all anymore.
Mm. So a lot of things have changed quickly.
Yes, a lot of things have changed quickly. And it's not only about, you know, the effect you have with your marketing activities when you really reach your target group. It's also about that if you, no one wants, you know, a spamming brand. So if you talk to a lot of people not interested in what you do, it also harms your brand. So it's both about how you communicate, but it's also extremely important to find the right target group. Even more important in times like this, I would say.
So what other risks do you see? Or maybe even better, how do I avoid risk?
Yeah. Yeah, I would say that's what we do at Biznode. It's about the data. I would say that data is your best friend during normal circumstances, but even more in times of crisis. A lot of business leaders still make important decisions based on gut feeling, but this is not the time to increase gut feeling in your decision making. You need to do the other way around. Data has never been more important in decision making than it is right now. So dare to trust the data, dare to trust the insights you get of the data, and also to make the right actions that the data tells you,
according to the data.
So you really dare to act on the insights. That's also really important. Not only get the insights, but you know,
you have to do something as well.
So
I often wished I had a crystal ball, especially maybe in times like it's. And you say that you kind of do.
Yeah, we have some kind of high tech crystal ball, but we call it the predictive analytics, and that is
crystal ball is cooler.
Yeah, it's cooler. Maybe we should say that instead. But it's like. It's a way of looking into the future. We call it predictive analytics, and that is a way to find out what your customer is going to buy next before they even know it themselves. And that is a really good tool, both for sales and for marketing. So we use historical data to predict what will happen in the future. Okay. So you combine different kind of data. You have customer data and you have transactional data, customers' buying behavior. But then you need to add some kind of analytical variables and maybe external data. And that's where the magic actually happens. And yeah, you could say it's a high-tech crystal ball, actually.
So how do I do that then? Where do I find my data and how do I decide where to aim my marketing focus?
Yeah, so you want to know how customers will behave in the future, and to be able to get that knowledge, you need to look into the history. So you start looking into your customer data, make sure it's up to date and that you know your customers. That's something that you already have in your company. And the transactional data you have as well. It's like how my customers' buying behavior in the past. Mm-hmm. And then you need... Often companies need help with the analytical variables, you know, where the magic happens, but it's not very complicated. It seems like it could be, but it's not. And it's a very, very powerful tool because then you will have the likability for different customers to buy your product and services in a prioritized order. Mm. And that's how you should, you know, aim your marketing campaigns according to the likability of customers buying your products or your services.
So then I want, as a customer, I will feel like I get the right information at the right time. And then I appreciate it.
Yeah, so that's when you don't you do not have to do the misdirected ads that both cost you a lot of money and harm your brand. Mm-hmm. So,
but you also recommend a deep dive into the closet and do kind of a spring cleaning, not with your clothes, but with your data.
Yeah. There is one golden principle when you work with data and with data-driven marketing, and that is the principle of shit in, shit out. So you really need to be in control of your data before you start your data-driven journey. 40% of your CRM system is not up to date. That's general
really?
Figures. Yeah. So if you start your data-driven journey based
sounds like
on
my closet.
Yeah. It's like if you start your data-driven journey based on that data, you will get the wrong insights and you will take the wrong actions. So that could be really, really bad for your business. So you really need to make sure that you are in control of the data. And there is a really simple way to do that. And it's just to take a sample and test your data okay. to see if it's up to date. Actually, there are a lot of companies that think that their data quality is bad. But when we test the data for them, they realize that it's actually really good. And in that case, data becomes your superpower if you are in control of your data. So it's not difficult.
Everyone needs a superpower these days.
Yeah, but remember, shit in, shit out. Don't start your data-driven journey on bad data.
Oh, okay, so you need to do the cleaning first.
You need to do the cleaning first.
So to sum up this conversation, what are your best tips moving forward, trying to communicate us through this crisis?
First of all, I will say that marketing is sales. A lot of companies needs revenue right now, and marketing is a really, really important part of that. Marketing is going digital, and a lot of marketing departments have become digital, but not all of them. Is that the case? You really need to become digital right now because COVID-19 really pushed the speed button on digital transformation.
And we're
right
not
now.
Going back, right?
And we are not going back. So things moved fast before, but now it's moving even faster. So that's one thing. The other thing is that you really need to find your purpose here because now we really need to listen to companies that can explain the role they have in society. Why should I care about your company? How do you contribute? What is your purpose? That's things that you probably know, but you do not use it in communication all the time. So really purpose-driven communication. And finally, it's about the data. Don't forget that data is your best friend right now.
Your superpower.
Yeah, it's your superpower. It's your best friend. Mm-hmm. When everything is uncertain around you, hold on to the data because that's the best thing you have when you're going to make decisions. So even though there are uncertainties, data is still your best friend out there. Mm.
Thank you so much, Anna, for being here with us today. I'm sure our viewers got a lot of good tips on how to move forward in this very strange and different environment. Thank you.
Thank you.
And for more episodes of BizNode Studio, please check out the website. Thank you for watching today and stay safe.